First, though, we are still cleaning up from some severe weather that hit our area last night. Here's a look at the damage we saw this morning. This is on Parker Road in the Great Bridge area of the city. As you can see, a tree fell on a power line. Dominion Energy had several thousand outages overnight. Right now, that number is down to a couple hundred in small pockets across the region. Dominion Energy is working to get everyone back on. Meanwhile, Governor Ralph Northam declared a state of emergency following storms that ripped through parts of the state last night.
It got pretty rough for some of us that had to be out in it. Stephanie Harris joins us now. She's following the developments from our newsroom. Stephanie?
Don and Katie, the governor tweeted this morning that he made the declaration to help local and state agencies respond to damage from the extreme weather. Let's take a look at what they're dealing with. This is in the Danville area in south central Virginia. Dozens of trees and power lines got knocked down in the storm. A similar scene in Lynchburg. Drivers are being asked to stay off of the roads and away from down power lines that could be hot. Schools are closed and thousands are without power. They might not have it back on until tomorrow. In Amherst County, an estimated 20 homes were destroyed in the severe weather. That's according to our sister station WFXR. Authorities tell them that approximately 6 to 7 people have been injured there as well. At least one person reported seeing a funnel cloud.
Got an alert on the phone of the tornado warning, and I was looking out my window and I saw the funnel cloud coming, and it came right over the house and went right up the hollow behind my house and came toward 58, and it was just twisting trees off like popsicle sticks.
Now, the National Weather Service has not yet confirmed a tornado touchdown. I'll continue to follow developments throughout the day. Look for updates on WAVY News 10 at 4 and on WAVY.com. Stephanie Harris, 10 on your side.